came from humble roots to rule a nation.
President Warren G. Harding, as I live and breathe, let's show these fancy Washington folk what an Ohio boy can do.
Mr. Speaker, the President of the United States.
But behind the public face lived a man of dark ambition.
Gentlemen, raise them up.
To the 29th President of these United States, and to our very good fortune.
Driven by hidden passions beyond his control and beyond the realm of virtue.
Mr. Harding, I do believe you're flirting with me.
Consumed by a lust that would not weaken.
Take me, Warren.
His name was synonymous with grace and dignity.
Mr. President?
Doomed to pay the price of power.
Mr. President, I must ask you again to sign an executive order about this Teapot Dome matter. You will sign this document.
Torn between duty and desire.
I demand to see my Warren.
Young lady, you're in no position to demand anything.
How dare you speak to me this way?
You look me in the eye and tell me she means nothing to you. Don't you turn your back on me, Warren.
He risked all he held dear.
If you don't contain the situation, this whole administration is going down. Do you hear me? We will all be finished.
Is that all I am to you, a plaything? I'm not your whore!
Why must my greatest love also be my greatest trial?
The New York Times calls it a movie. The LA Times raves. There are 4 Oscar nominees in it. Seriously. And World of Wax Monthly hails Harding as a triumph. Campbell Scott, Anna Kendrick, Michael McKean, James Cromwell, and Laura fucking Linney.
You are a great man, Warren. But heed my warning. Even great men may be corrupted.
Soon.